Thank you. brings a tremendous sense of pride, especially to see some of our former students come back and join us. So we're very glad to have you as well. It's an absolute honor to have each of you with us here today. You're why we're here. You're the star of the show. So we're very thankful that you're here, and we want to do the best job we can to pay our respects and show you how much we appreciate each of you. I also want to acknowledge the members of our district administration team who have made attending this morning a priority. We have with us, among them, our superintendent, Ms. Shannon Dillon Miller, right here in the front row. You know you're important when she won't take time out of running the school system to be here and share this moment with you. This is one of the most important events that we do here at Fannin County High School. It's my favorite thing to do, because it gives our students the opportunity to see firsthand some of the people who are responsible for the freedoms, the rights, and the liberties that we have in this country. You know, we hear about it, we study about it, but there's nothing as impactful as seeing the men and women who have been part of it, and the men and women who have made it possible for us to be here today. It gives me an immense measure of pride in our students, in our staff, and in our community when I see the respect that we give and the esteem we hold our veterans in. Our military, both past and present, have made a tremendous impact on this country. They've made a tremendous impact on each and every life sitting here today. Because you have the right to be here today. You have the right to free education. You have the right to your beliefs. Because the men and women sitting here in these front rows have made that sacrifice to go forth and to defend those rights. And it is a tremendous amount of gratitude that we owe each and every one of them. This program is a very small way that we here at Fannin County High School want to say a huge thank you to the men and women who answered the call to serve and protect this nation that we hold so dear. So, before I turn this over to our Master of Ceremonies, please join me in giving a rousing round of applause to our veterans who are ready to go.
And I'm a member of this year's senior class. At this time, I would like to ask that everyone please When your song is played, please rise for recognition. Army!
Good morning. If I could direct your attention to this empty chair. This empty chair is a physical symbol of the thousands of American prisoners and the missing in action from all the wars and conflicts that our great country has been involved in. The chair cover is a reminder for all of us to spare no effort to secure the release of any American prisoners still in captivity, and the return of the remains of those who have died bravely in defense of our liberty, and a full accounting of all those missing. We owe them much more than this. We must not forget the sacrifices these comrades are still making today and the suffering they're still enduring. They must remain alive in our minds and our hearts.
until we know they have returned to their families and loved ones, or they dwell in the house of our Lord. We must continue to give moral support to the families who continue to suffer along with them. From World War I, our country has had over 142,000 prisoners of war. And from World War II to present day, our country has had over 95,000 missing in action or still unaccounted for. And I'm very sad to report that this number is still climbing today. Now that's nearly 250,000 that we know of, but that really doesn't paint the whole picture, does it? Let's think about something for a second. These nearly 250,000 men and women had families, mothers, fathers, wives, husbands, children, aunts, uncles, cousins, not to mention all the friends and the neighbors. So when we talk about these numbers, that number is not correct. It's much higher. There are hundreds of thousands of people still missing their loved ones, some still suffering. Now, tomorrow is Veterans Day, and that's the day set aside to honor veterans. But let me remind you of something. We enjoy our freedoms each and every day, not just tomorrow, not on Veterans Day. So if you see and recognize a veteran, I think it would be a pretty good idea if you walked up to them, took their hand and shook it and said, thank you, because we are free people because of them. We are enjoying today because of them. And you know, we enjoy our freedoms each and every day, just not on November the 11th. This is a very patriotic county. This is the most patriotic county I've ever been involved with, and I really appreciate it here. This is a wonderful school system. I pray that God continues to bless the school system, the students, the parents, the teachers, the administrators, and everybody involved in this county. And may God bless the United States of America.
Sergeant Bill Stodge of the United States Air Force. Mike Campbell, Army. Tommy Henson, E4. E5, Harold Mizell, Army. Robert Mills, United States Navy, Submarine Corps. Private 2, Daniel Henderson, Georgia Army Guard. E4, Billy Mitchell, Army Reserve. Sergeant Major Jerry Tucker, United States Army. First Sergeant David Morrison, Army. Sergeant E5, Steve Cheeto, United States Army. Bill Prather, Specialist 5, United States Army. Staff Sergeant Jim Ezel, United States Air Force. Sergeant Johnny Swords, United States Army. Katrina Armaliagueta, United States Army Captain. Lieutenant Colonel Alicia Wallace, United States Air Force. Corporal Jody Callahan, United States Marine Corps. Petty Officer First Class Sterling Callahan, United States Navy. Privateer Katrina McQuigg, United States Army. Lance Corporal Gary Queen, United States Marine. Spec 4 Paul Hunter, United States Army. Specialist 4th Class Sonny Payne, United States Army. Staff Sergeant Richard Crosley, United States Air Force. Sergeant Bruce Fowler, United States Army. Sergeant Kevin O'Quinn, United States Air Force. Sergeant First Class Ronnie Raven, United States Army. Specialist David Henson, United States Army. Chief Petty Officer Gerald McMillan, United States Coast Guard.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in recognizing these courageous men and women who have faithfully served our country. A veteran means you can live safely in our country.
A veteran means to me that somebody that risked it all going to a war to protect us here at home.
A veteran means to me somebody who sacrificed everything just to give me my freedom.
A veteran is a person who sacrifices everything for their community, for their family, for their friends, and for their freedom.
A veteran is someone who's willing to sacrifice a lot for the country.
For the country, the people, and do it with honor, and some have lost their lives in the process, so much for me today, and we appreciate that.
Thank you, veterans. Thank you, veterans.
Thank you, veterans. Thank you, veterans.
Thank you, veterans.
She graduated from Traffic Management Technical School at Lackland Air Force Base in Texas in November 2002. She has served in leadership positions at bases in the United Kingdom, Turkey, and South Carolina. Additionally, Master Sergeant Ash has deployed in support of NATO-led European Union Force, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Operation Enduring Freedom, and Inherent Resolve. Currently, she is Headquarters U.S. Air Force Traffic Manager assigned to the Logistics but was quickly taken up by both the North and South, being sounded by buglers and both Union and Confederate forces. TAPS is used today by American servicemen as an end-of-day lights-out signal. In addition, it is a vital component in ceremonies honoring military members that have passed away. When TAPS is played at a military funeral, it is customary to salute, if in uniform, or place your hand over your heart. Would everyone now please rise for the playing of TAPS and the retiring of the colors? Retire the colors.
As I said when I opened, this is one of the most important things we do here. And I hope that you have seen throughout this program the respect and honor that we give you as veterans. The special thing about this program is it's done by students and it's put on by students. And it was said earlier today that Fannin County is one of the most patriotic places that there is. What a great description. And what a great place to live. I think that goes back to the people that make up this county and the respect that we have for those who have served our country and those who have provided us with the freedoms that we have. I'm always so proud of our students and the respect that they show to each and every one of you and the understanding that they have of what it means to be a veteran and what it means to have their rights defended each and every day. I want to thank each of you for coming. It means so much to us to have you here, to have you in our building, and you are always welcome. Every day is Veterans Day, okay? So it doesn't just have to be this one time a year. You are welcome to come. We would love to have you. Also, our students, our family and consumer science students and teachers have prepared a meal for you, as is the custom. So I would invite and ask that each of you stay and take part in that meal. And you know, if you have a family member here, certainly go down and join them on that. Another way that we want to say thank you for your service and thank you for being here. So just one final time, and before we go back to class and get on with the job of educating these young minds, just one final time, let's give our veterans a round of applause.
We'll head back to class.